Welcome to the Cathedral Church of All Saints, Wakefield. I'm sitting with Jonathan Bielby at the organ console. Jonathan, you've been here for 25 years. What changes have you seen over those years while you've been here?
Vast changes, certainly in the liturgy, with the new orders of service that we've had, and we've had to decide how to deal with those and to make sure we don't throw out the baby with the bathwater and keep the good music, but also try and bring in newly commissioned music that is worth performing. We've seen the rebuild of the organ. When I came in 1970, the actions were sluggish and the capture systems were antiquated. And we had an empty choir organ case above our heads. Now, with the rebuild in 84, 85, everything sparkles, the sound's marvellous. We've got the best of the Compton extension work, and we've got the choir division above our heads singing out, as you can hear in many of the pieces I play.
So what's this first piece you're going to play that's going to show off the organ?
It's Bach's great B minor, Prelude and Fugue, and to contrast with the great division, every now and again I go onto the choir and you can hear the sparkling sounds very well reproduced.
Thank you.
Bach's Prelude and Fugue in B minor, The Great, played by Jonathan Bielby. The next piece you've chosen, Jonathan, is quite different, isn't it?
Yes, it's by our famous old boy, Kenneth Leighton, who was born in Wakefield.
Kenneth Leighton's Veni Creator Spiritus, played by Jonathan Bielby on the organ of Wakefield Cathedral. The next piece you're going to play, Jonathan, is one by Howells, isn't it? That has a special association for you, is that right?
That's right. It's a psalm prelude, and it was the last piece that I played on the organ before it was taken to bits for the rebuild. And it was the first piece that was played at the rededication of the organ. It's in the Grand Cathedral style. It sounds wonderful on this organ, and we have something on this organ which is very strange, which is to have the great division enclosed. And if you listen for the last chord, you'll hear a marvellous surge of crescendo, which is achieved by that.
So let's hear Herbert Howells' Psalm Prelude, set to number 3, based on Psalm 33, Sing Unto Him a New Song.
Thank you.
Herbert Howells' Psalm Prelude, set to number 3, Sing Unto Him a New Song, played by Jonathan Bielby. There must be elements of fun as well as all the serious music that you play. Do you have any particular events or periods that stand out over the past 25 years?
I've sometimes written pieces for members of the choir, and I also wrote a piece for the opening of the organ, a surprise piece for the builders, Wood of Huddersfield, who had done us so proud. And I was looking for a piece which involved the words organs and woods, and I can tell you there's nothing in the Bible that fits the bill at all, but I found something in Edmund Spenser, which I set to music, and they go like this. Let the roaring organs loudly play the praises of the Lord in lively notes. The wiles with hollow throats, the choristers, the joyous anthems sing, that all the woods may answer and their echo ring. And the Yorkshire Post got hold of this and in their People column put the headline, Polished Woodwork.
Oh, dear. So there are one or two groans in this next piece that you're going to play, aren't there? So this is
many groans. Yes, it's a fun piece, which I wrote in 1994. With its different variations, it shows off many of the different sounds of the organ. Each variation is in the style of a different composer. The theme is hinted at first, but it becomes obvious fairly soon. I'm not going to tell you what the theme is. It's all great fun with Yorkshire connections.
So let's hear your 9 variations on a well-known tune.
Jonathan Bielby at the organ of Wakefield Cathedral in his own variations on a well-known tune. Talking to Jonathan Bielby was Claire Jaques. The producer was Julian Gregory.